All right. So hopefully you watched the last video on percents and you're going to have an idea what to do here. Let me ask you, what happens if you got a question that said, tell me what 3% is of 50? What is 3% of 50? Well, what you do is you start by changing this 3% into a decimal, just like we did in the previous lesson. So I'm going to do that, and if you forget what I'm doing, please go back and watch that other video. The word of, remember, it can be used as times. So 0.03 times 50. Take your calculator. 0.03 times 50. You get 1.5. All right, so 3% of 50 is 1.5. All right, now this is really good to know, especially when you're doing taxes. But before we do taxes, let's just do one more question, a little tougher one. What is 1.6% of 25? Well, remember, move this decimal over two places, first of all, from where it is right now. Okay, so it was here, and I moved it over one, two places. You're going to times that by 25. Type it in on your calculator. 0.016 times 25, and I get 0.4. Okay. So why would someone want to know how to do this? Well, actually, it's really important. If you're in a store and you want to buy a t-shirt for, let's say, $40, you walk up to the cash register and they say, "All right, that will be $40, please." No, it would not. You'd actually have to pay something in Ontario, which is HST. So you have to pay $40 plus the HST. Well, we know the HST in Ontario is 13%. And by the way, it doesn't matter which way you do this. You can go 40, which is the $40. You times that by 13% as a decimal. One, two. Doesn't matter what order you do it in. In the earlier examples, I went 0.13 times 40. I was showing it that way, but it doesn't matter what order, okay? It still works. Take your calculator, go 40 times 0.13, and you're going to get 5.2. Now, what does that 5.2 mean? We were talking about dollars here, and we just got 5.2. That's actually $5.2. It doesn't sound right. So then you say, wait a minute. It's $5.20. That looks more like money. That is how much tax gets added to the $40. So if a question says how much tax is added, you'd say $5.20. But if the question said what's the total price, then all you do is you take the $40 and add on what you got for the taxes, which was $5.20. You're going to get $45.20 as your total price. All right. You can always push stop right now and not watch anymore, but I'm going to show one more example just to make sure you got this, okay? I'll even use a different color just for giggles. All right. So you want to buy an iPod Touch, and it's $199. And you're going to have to figure out 13% tax. Well, 0.13. I just changed the 13% to a decimal, and I go 199 times 0.13, and I get this one actually works out nicely, $25. And 87 cents. That looks like a comma. It's supposed to be a decimal. I know in Europe they use what looks like a comma for a decimal. But anyway, so 199 plus the tax, which was 25 87 gives us our total. All right, 199 plus 2587, we get $224. This is always the hard part at the till. It's so much more expensive than you thought it was. $224.87. The government gets the 13%, which kind of hurts. All right, folks. So that's how you do the total cost when you have taxes going on. Right on.